In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a cheap mobile phone power bank and upgrade the really rubbish battery that they come with from a 1.2 amp hour battery to something like a 2.6 or a 2.7 amp hour battery. Now, I can't complain too much because this power bank cost £1 from a pound shop, and it comes with a little lanyard, it has a little charging cable, and the power bank itself. So, you know, it's not really a bad thing for a pound, given that the circuit itself I've seen advertised on eBay for a pound. Anyway, so what I'm gonna do is, the cell inside is one of these 1.2 amp hour cells, so they're only 3.7 volts as well. So by the time it's charged your phone, you're probably only looking at about 800 or 900 milliamp hour of power. So you'll be very lucky if you get a full charge out of your phone with one of these. But by the time we've upgraded it, you should get a full charge out of your phone and maybe another half charge as well. So, first thing you gotta do is, it's really straightforward to do these. Let's get rid of these because I've done these already. There's no seal or anything like that to worry about. It's just pushed in. So you just have to get a small screwdriver and just open the back of the plastic. Just get one in there, a small one if you can, and then use a slightly larger one, and then just carefully ping up the plastic that's sealing the little unit. And that's fairly easy to do. Just work my way around. For this job, you're gonna need a soldering iron, some scissors, solder. But if you don't have a soldering iron, you could probably do it with a glue gun as well. And if you don't have a glue gun, you could probably just do it with insulation tape. It would probably work just as well. So this is inside the little unit. So if I just lever out the battery, you can see it's just a very straightforward design. A little bit of foam on the back just to give it some pressure, which I'll be peeling off with any luck. And then the charge unit itself, and then the charge goes in there, and then the supply goes in there. So these are 18650 cells. You can get these from plenty of sources. I personally choose to recycle old laptop battery packs because I know that the power supplies in here, the batteries in here, I know they're going to be a genuine 2.6 or 2.8 amp hour cell. You could go onto eBay and buy cells that are basically like this, and they would have maybe 5 amp hour or 2 or 3 amp hour on there. In fact, I saw somebody doing a similar video to this, and I'm pretty certain that they took out a 2.5 amp hour battery and put in something like a 1.5 amp hour battery. It just had a load of rubbish amps claims printed on the side. So personally, I always use laptop cells because you know the power supply is going to be genuine. So just take off the little bit of rubber off the back. Now, if you're better at it than me with a soldering gun, and I'm not too brilliant with a soldering gun, you might be able to just tap some heat on there and just peel those tabs off. But I can't be bothered to do that for this video, so I'm just gonna snip those off. And providing I leave plenty of space left to resolder them to the new battery, it's not really gonna be a problem. So, okay, so once you've got the charge unit out, don't worry too much if you don't actually manage to keep these tabs. They can fly off fairly easily because we're going to solder these on. Now, if you haven't got a soldering iron, you can just push them on there and put a bit of glue on there from a glue gun, or you can just tape it with insulation tape like I've got here. But I'm going to attempt to solder these on because it's just going to give me a better result. I say attempt because I haven't got the world's best soldering iron here, and we'll be lucky if it works. So let's see how we get on here. So I couldn't find my butane powered soldering iron, which is much better than this one. So I'm just putting a little bit of base of electricity of solder on there. The positive is always the top pack out with a little plastic or paper ring that's attached on there, and the negative is always the bottom with the flat side. Okay, that one's done there. Not the world's best job, so I'm just gonna put a little piece of tape over that just to hold that in place. which I'll do after I've done the bottom one. Just hold that in there while I put some solder on the tail. And then hopefully I can get that into there. Okay, and that one's done there. It's not the world's best solder, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to cover it in insulation tape just to hold it in place. And that just goes around there. Means when I put the thing back inside, it doesn't actually have much chance of breaking the solder that I've done very badly. Okay, so what I found when I was practicing this is it's actually easier to line the charge unit up and then put a USB cable in just to connect it up, and then connect it up to the USB cable inside. Because you can then use that to pull it through into position. Like that. Just be careful not to trap the wires when I push them back in. And there we go. That's done. Let me charge, see if I can charge something. Plug it into my mobile phone. And it's charging. That's all pretty good. So there you go, that's how to upgrade a cheap pound shop power bank from 1.2 amp or 900 amp to 2.5 amp hour battery pack. Thank you for watching.